belittle the Dajjal, and sometime he will make of a mention that is of a high mention. وَرَفَعَ, meaning he will, sort of word, he will be speaking so, yani so in detail about this, to the point that he's giving him a great importance. And in some time he is, barakallahu fikum, he say, فَخَفَضَ فِيهِ, he will belittle the Dajjal. He will make it insignificant. And at some time he will make it very important. Huh? Very significant, barakallahu fikum. Sometime that he will talk about it in a very insignificant way. And sometime he will talk about it in a very, very significant way. So therefore, فَتَحَدَّثَ لِلنَّاسِ فَتَحَدَّثَ النَّاسِ فِي هَذَا. And he say, وَإِن تَهَكُوا وَإِن هَمَا وَإِن هَمَكُوا فِيهِ وَإِن هَمَكُوا فِيهِ. And he say that the people that they were talking in regard to this, and they were a little bit in regard to confuse why the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sometime he will talk about the Dajjal so insignificantly, and sometime how he talked about the Dajjal very significantly. So the people, they were a little bit, barakallahu fikum, yani confused about that issue. So therefore, ثُمَّ قَالُوا لِرَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. So therefore, they approached the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. They told him, the Rasul Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, إِنَّكَ تَكَلَّمْتَ عَلَى الدَّجَّالِ, that you have spoken in regard to the Dajjal. He said, وَخَفَّضْتَ فِيهِ وَرَفَعْتَ وَكَذَا وَكَذَا. قَالَ غَيْرُ الدَّجَّالِ أَخْوَفُنِي عَلَيْكُمْ. He say that, they say that, ya Rasul, you Messenger of Allah, sometime you speak about the Dajjal in a form that he is, it is very significant. And at some point you speak about him in a form that is very insignificant. And you speak about this, you speak about that, meaning wakadha, wakadha. Qala, and the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to them, غَيْرُ الدَّجَّالِ أَخْوَفُنِي عَلَيْكُمْ. Other than the Dajjal, I fear the most for you. Other than the Dajjal, I fear the most for you. Now, akhi, look at this. Other than the Dajjal, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told that he fears for us. Now, the Sahaba, they see how the Messenger will talk about the Dajjal. He will talk about it with a great amount of significance. And sometimes he will talk about it in a very, yani, insignificant level. So the companion, they went to them, they asked the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam about how he talks about the Dajjal. So he told them this word, غَيْرُ Dajjal, other than the Dajjal, أَخْوَفُنِي عَلَيْكُمْ, that I fear the most for you. He say, لِأَنَّ Dajjal, why? Because the Dajjal, مَكْتُوبٌ عَلَى جَبْهَتِهِ كَافِرٌ, because the Dajjal, it is clear, it is written, inscribed on his forehead, the word kafir, meaning these three letters, kaf, fa, and ra. This is what is being inscribed on his, inscribed on his forehead. This is what is written on his forehead, kaf, fa, ra. Yaqra'u al-mu'min. Now look at this. He mentioned that the believer, yaqra'u al-mu'min alladhi yaktub walladhi la yaktub. The literate believer and the illiterate believer, they will both be able to read it. Bisababi ash, bisababi imanihim, ahsanta ustaz. Bisababi imanihim, because of their belief. So the one that know how to write, tayyib, meaning the one that is lettered, and the one that is illiterate, both of them will be able to read it. Tayyib, he say here, alladhi la yaktub, wala وَالَّذِي يَكْتُبْ, meaning the one that write and the one that doesn't write. So here, the fact of writing, meaning that the person can, if a person can write, it means he can read. Right? If a person can write, it means he can read. So the word الَّذِي يَكْتُبْ وَالَّذِي لَا يَكْتُبْ, it is to define the one that is literate and the one that is illiterate. So he mentioned, he say, آيَةً وَادِحَةٌ أو آيَةٌ وَادِحَةٌ بِأَنَّهُ كَافِرٌ بِخِلَافِ الَّذِي يُلَبِّسْ لِبَاسَ إِسْلَامِيًّا. He say that it is clear that Dajjal is a disbeliever. It is clear he is a disbeliever. Unlike the one that is adorning himself with the adornment of the religion. He said, الذي يلبس لباسا إسلاميا. طيب. Like the one that will adorn himself with the Islamic adornment. وبإسم الإسلام, and in the name of Islam, or in the name of Islam. ويحمل, he say, and likewise he will be carrying شعار الإسلامي. He will be carrying the slogan or Islamic slogan. Let's say, you know, they're talking about the Sunnah, or now it is a slogan about Salafiyah. People that, akhi, 2 years ago, a year ago, where were they? Did you ever heard them say Salafiyah in their mouth? Now it's a, for them, now it's a slogan. It's a slogan that you gotta say to be in line. It's a slogan, it's like words to say, Barakallahu fikum. So these individuals, they will have the adornment of the Islamic adornment. And in the name of Islam, and وَيَحْمِلُوا شِعَارًا إِسْلَامِيًا, and they will be taking the slogan of meaning carrying the Islamic slogan. طيب. He said, هَذَا يَضُرُّ أَكْثَرُ, and this is causing more harm than the Dajjal that is known. Than the Dajjal that is known. How many people has been misguided by Mufti Menk? And yet he has this very nice, what you call it? Pressed ghutra. Always crispy. Comb his lihya, make a nice appearance, talk the talk that the people want to hear. But he's not guiding them to the way of the Sahaba. He's not guiding them to the way of the companion. He's not guiding them to the way of the Sunnah. But rather he's guiding them to other than the way of the Sunnah. Even though he might use the word what? Sahaba. Even though he might use the word the Sunnah. Even though you might hear him say what? Tawheed. Now taking the cloak of what? The libas of the religion. Tayyip. But, and then also carrying out some of the Islamic slogan. So the Shaykh Hafidhul, he say, هذا يضر أكثر. And this will cause more harm. How many people on YouTube have millions of hits, while the likes of those who are the most deserving to be having likes and hits are barakallahu fikum not having it? Where is Yasir Qadi? Thousands and millions of hits. Popular on YouTube. Huh? Arifi. Right? The one that was talking about the Surah Tufah wal-Iyadu Billah. Calling surah, there is, you know, talking about the surah of apple, the apple surah. Right? Talking bad about the Quran. Where are those that have millions of hits? While the scholars of the Sunnah, while those who are the Rabbaniyun, Barakallahu fikum walhamdulillah. And this is from the guidance of Allah, those who attach themselves to the likes of the scholars. This is a ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And do not pay attention to this individual that want to take you away from taking our religion from the ulama. The likes of Muhammad Munir, the likes of Shadid Muhammad, and like the likes of this individual. Talking about the scholars, you think that they will miss their morning tea because of your issue, your community issue? Akhi, this is to speak bad about the scholars. Akhi, even we call the scholars, we can't get him. We believe that he's mashghul. We don't believe that he's taking a nap. If he does, this is even good for us. Because his body has a right over him. But you're talking about the scholars, you think like the scholars, they're going to miss their morning date for your issues? Akhi, this is to speak bad about the scholars. So therefore, the Shaykh Hafidhahullah, Shaykh Rabi ibn Hadi al-Madkhali, may Allah give him good and give him a good end. I mean, he mentioned, he said, هَذَا يَضُرُّ أَكْثَرُ, and he said that this is causing more harm. This is causing more harm. He said, غَيْرُ الدَّجَّالِ أَخْوَفُنِي عَلَيْكُمْ. He said, more than the Dajjal do I fear for you. Meaning there are other ones that are out there that I fear for you other than the Dajjal.
The Shaykh Hafidhahullah, he mentioned, he say, هَؤُلَاءِ الْمُلَبِّسُونَ.
Those who are, mulabbis is someone that is changing of a color. Today he's taking one path, tomorrow he's taking another path. And subhanAllah, there was a khutbah that Shaykh Muhammad Raslan, Hafidhahullah, has made, showing how Ahlul Sunnah